discuss about more about chemical changes. This is chapter number 5. Okay. Now, in this chapter, we are going to learn about various aspects of chemical reaction. Okay. So, now, first of all, we will try to understand about what is your chemical bond. In the previous classes, during the chapter number 4, we have came across something like compounds like NaCl, MgCl2, MgO. Okay. Now, these are known as chemical compounds. Okay. Now, what happens in the chemical compounds? You can see that this chemical compound is formed by how many elements here? Two elements, Na and Cl. It means that Na and Cl have been combined together to form what? NaCl. That means before Na and Cl were separate. Okay. And after doing some chemical reaction, they became NaCl. That means this Na is holding Cl by some amount of force. Okay. And this Cl is holding the Na by some amount of force here. Now this is force, okay, is known as the chemical bond. Okay. So chemical bond means this is a bond in which two substances will hold together, okay, to form a compound here. Now if you know about the chemical bond, after that we can discuss about the chemical reaction here. In chemical reaction, what happens here? Suppose you take one substance like H2O. Okay. Now, if I heat this H2O, that is our water, what we are going to get? This H2O is going to break to form H2NO2. Now, you can see here, before it was a single compound, and after the reaction, it became how many compounds here? Two compounds. That means, here it was water, and here it is hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. That means, there is something occurred here due to which new substances are formed. So, what you can say that a chemical reaction, in a chemical reaction, the old substance, okay, or the substance breaks down to give two or more substances. So you can say new substances are formed here. You can say that a substance, when a substance reacts, okay, and when a new substances are formed after the reaction, that type of reaction is known as chemical reaction here. You can see that in a chemical reaction, you can see there are two parts, okay. One is the left side of the arrow, other is the right side of the arrow, okay. Now this left side of the arrow is known as reactant, means which is going to take part in the reaction, in which are the going to react here, okay. And after reacting, after the chemical reaction has been occurred, you got some outcome, isn't it? This outcome is known as the product here, correct. So now in a chemical reaction, we know that a substance is going to break or is going to combine, depending upon the type of reaction, is going to form new substances. Okay, if in a type of reaction, if new substances are formed, then it is considered to be chemical reaction. And in a chemical reaction, we have reactant and we have the product. The substances which react, they are known as the reactant, and the outcome of the reaction is known as the product here. Now, you should know one more thing here. Okay, from this, okay, after we know the chemical reaction allow, you can justify or classify it like two categories. Okay, one is your balanced chemical equation and other one is your unbalanced chemical equation. Now you should always remember that if you want a chemical reaction to occur and if you want the outcome of the chemical reaction, you have to always make your chemical reaction balanced. Okay, so balanced means how we are going to make it balanced. Let's learn in a simple way. Make it, so let us say one example like H2O. Or you can write like this, H2 plus O2 combined to give you H2, means hydrogen gas combined with oxygen gas to give you water, this is H2. Now this reaction will not be complete until and unless each side of the reactant and product are balanced. So means what is the balance then means, you can see here that we have hydrogen here and we have oxygen here, and you can see the other side also. We have hydrogen and oxygen. Now, if you try to follow the reaction, you can see that although new substances are formed here, but you can see the elements are not changed. Here we have hydrogen, oxygen, in the outcome also we have hydrogen and oxygen. It is not like this that we have hydrogen and oxygen here, in the outcome we are getting sodium. It cannot happen, okay? So, whatever elements that you have before the reaction, you should have the same element after the reaction also. Now, We are concentrating on how to balance the reaction. Now, for balancing the reaction, first of all, you write it down. You just see the hydrogen here. How many hydrogen I have? Hydrogen what I have here? Two. Then I have how many hydrogen here? Two hydrogen. Come to oxygen, how many oxygen I have here? Two oxygen. Now we have the side of reactant, we are having two hydrogen and two oxygen. Now go to the product side. Now come here, how many, you can just see the hydrogen here. You can just take it off, how many hydrogen we have here now? Two. And how many oxygen we have here? We have here how much here? Only one. Now if you just come to the core side, you can see two hydrogen, two hydrogen. This is balanced for us, for the time being. But see as the oxygen, how many oxygen we have here? Two. Okay, how many oxygen we have here? Only one. Now this is not balanced, okay? So what you have to do here? We have to make it balanced now. So to make it balanced, then we have to remember some rules, okay? You cannot write 2 here to make it balanced. That is not possible, okay? Because you know the water formula is H2O. If you write it H2O2, it will not give you the formula of water here. So you cannot write here. We cannot write here also. If you want to write anything, we have to write in the beginning of the compound. Suppose here, before H2O, we wrote here 2 here. So now, when you wrote these two here, these two is not only for oxygen, okay? These two is for hydrogen also and these two is for oxygen also. So 2 to the how much will come here? 4 hydrogen and 2 into 1 is how much here? 2 oxygen. Now with this side you have 4 hydrogen and 2 oxygen. But come this side, how much we have? Before we had 2, but now this side we have 4, this side we have 2. Now this is not balanced, okay? If you balance it, you make it 4 here. To make it 4, what do you do here? We have to write here. Now you can take it out. 2 is how much hydrogen? 4 hydrogen. 2 is how much hydrogen? 4 hydrogen. How many oxygen here? 2 oxygen. How many oxygen here? 2 oxygen. Now once the chemical reaction is over, that means your chemical, so once your balancing is over, it means that your chemical reaction is complete, okay? Now if you take little bit more examples, okay? Suppose, let us take one more example, like nitrogen gas, okay? And hydrogen gas combines to form NH3. Now that is your ammonia, okay? We have already gone in the last chapter that NH3 is the formula of ammonia. Now let us take it down, okay? If you have to balance it, then like make it like this, N2, H2 gives you what? NH3 here. Now make it here, how many nitrogen I have here? Nitrogen is here, how much? 2. How many hydrogen I have here? Hydrogen is here, 2. Come here now. How many nitrogen? Only 1. And how many hydrogen I have here? We have here 3 hydrogen. Now it is not at all balanced, okay? So first try to balance your nitrogen here. How many nitrogen here? 2. But here how much I have? 1. So now I want to make it 2 here. Remember here, you cannot write anything here. So whatever you have to write, you write before the formula here. That means you have to write the 2 here. As soon as I wrote 2 here, how many nitrogen it became? 2 nitrogen. But before also I said, this 2 is not only for nitrogen, okay? This 2 is for hydrogen also. So this downside and upside will be multiplied. Not plus, okay? Not 3 plus 2, okay? This 3 into 2. 3 into how much here? 6. That means this is how many hydrogen I have? 6 hydrogen. Now come here, how many hydrogen I have here? Only 2. I have to make it 6. So what I write here? I write here 3. That means 3 to the 6. Okay, so we have already learned how to balance the chemical equation. Okay. In the exercise, we have more questions. We will be getting more questions how to balance it. Okay. And more and some more questions you are going to get in the homework also. Now, we are going to discuss about the next type. Next topic is about types of chemical reaction. Okay. We discuss about chemical reaction, but chemical reaction are of many types. If you go to higher classes, okay, now we are going to discuss only around 3 to 4 types. Okay. But if you go to higher classes, you are going to get many types of chemical reaction like combination, decomposition, displacement, double displacement, you are going to get oxidation, reduction, okay? And you are going to get rusting, corrosion, rancidity, and if you go more higher, it will be more type of chemical reaction going to come, okay? But for time being, we will discuss only few of them. Number one is your combination reaction. Now, with the name itself, okay? You can see that in the name itself, there is something what combined, okay? That means something is going to combine here. So now, a combination reaction is a type of reaction in which two substances combine to form a single substance. Okay, very simple. Means two substances will be there, they are combining, and after combining they are going to form what? A single substance. So for example, the main example, we can take a simple example like H2NO2, okay? So you can just see here, there is hydrogen gas, there is oxygen gas. Now they will combine and they will form what? H2O. If you want to balance it, you can balance it also. Now you can see here, how many substances are here? Two substances. They combine together and then how many substances here? One substance. So this type of chemical reaction where two substances combine to form single substance or a new substance is known as the combination reaction, okay? Number two is your decomposition. Decomposition reaction. Okay, now again from the name itself we can find out what they are meaning to say here. Okay, decompose means what? Breaking down. Okay, means it will break down here. That means here, decomposition reaction is a type of chemical reaction in which a single substance, or you can say a single complex substance, will not actually decompose, okay? With a better word, what you can get, will break down to give two or more new substance. Okay? So, for example, you can start with this example, like make it like MgO. Correct? This is magnesium oxide. Now, you should remember here, for a decomposition reaction, means you are going to break the substance. Okay? If you are going to break the substance, what is going to happen here? That means, for breaking any substance, you need to apply some amount of force. But this is a chemical formula, but this chemical substance, we cannot apply force here. Okay? We have to supply here energy. Now, this energy can be in the form of heat, it can be in the form of light, it can be in the form of electricity. Okay? In any source, you can provide the energy. Now, suppose if I heat, okay, so we burn something and try to heat this with magnesium oxide. Then, due to the energy provided by the heat, this magnesium oxide is going to break and form MgNO2. Okay, magnesium gas and oxygen gas. If you balance it, 2 Mg, here 2 Mg, 2 oxygen, here 2 oxygen. Okay. Now, what you learn about now from here, you learn that decomposition reaction is a type of reaction in which a complex substance is going to break down to give two or more new substances. Okay, there are complex reactions are here. We'll be discussing it later on. Okay, but let's try to make it simple here. If you suppose if I take it like this, silver chloride, okay, AgCl. So now if you heat the silver chloride, okay, what's going to happen? This silver chloride is going to break and going to form silver and chlorine gas here. Okay, so this is also a type of decomposition reaction. Okay, now if you want to know more about decomposition reaction, see, decomposition reaction also can be classified into 3 types. Okay, one is your thermal decomposition, other one is your photolytic decomposition, other one is your electrolysis decomposition. Okay, in thermal decomposition, the energy which will be supplied to break the substances will be in the form of heat. Okay, in the photolytic decomposition, the energy which is going to be supplied is going to be in the form of sunlight or light. Okay, and the electrolysis, here the energy is going to be supplied in the form of electricity. Okay, so there are 3 types of decomposition reaction here. Now our next topic will be displacement reaction. Now again from the name you can come to a conclusion that here something is going to occur, like something is going to displace, something related to displace is going to occur here. So now number 3 we have displacement reaction. Okay, so now here what happens, suppose like if you assume, okay, suppose here one person, okay, make it Big Show, okay, got it. Okay, so this is a wrestler called Big Show here. Now here another wrestler, make it like Santino Morata. Santino, okay. Now you just try to assume here, who is more stronger here? Big Show is more stronger or Santino is more stronger? So obviously we know that Big Show is more stronger. Okay, now if I make them fight, what's going to happen here? Obviously Big Show is going to defeat the Santino, isn't it? Now if I think that if Santino is a WWE champion, okay, and if Big Show wants to become a WWE champion, what Big Show need to do? Big Show need to come and defeat the Santino. Okay, so here we are just talking about the example like defeating and all, but here it's not like defeating. Here it's not about power. Okay, here it is about reactivity. Now in a displacement reaction, what happens? A more reactive element, okay, the element, or you can say atom also, a more reactive element or a more reactive atom will displace. Displace means remove, okay? Will displace the less reactive element to form a new compound, okay? Means, suppose like, let us take 2 examples, like, make it like this one, okay? CuSO4, 4 and plus I am taking here what? Sodium here. Okay. Now you can see here, this is your copper sulfate and this is your sodium here. Okay. This copper is the metal and this Na is a metal here. Okay. We can say element or you can make it your metal also. No problem. Okay. Now if you see here, sodium, this element, okay, sodium is what? More reactive than whom? Copper. Okay, since sodium is more reactive than copper, the sodium is going to come and displace, or you can say replace the copper from its substance, from the compound to form new compound, something like this. Okay, this Na will come from here. Since Na is more reactive, or you can say Na is more powerful than copper, Na is going to displace the copper from here and will form Na2SO4. And this copper will come out from the compound. Okay. So this type of reaction where a more reactive element displaces a less reactive element is known as the displacement reaction. Okay. Now there are many other type of reaction like double displacement reaction, oxidation, reduction. Okay. We are not going to discuss now. This is not the part of our course here. So one more thing we need to know is that one more type of reaction is there, that is known as rusting. Okay, now this thing, this particular reaction we have all seen, okay. Now, you might have noticed that whenever a person makes a bomb with the help of tins and all, then you will be looking at the tin, the color of tin was different, the silver color in the beginning, okay. But as the time will pass by, you will see that the shininess of the tin, that is the silver color, have disappeared and you can see that a reddish brown color is to appear, okay, on the particular matter. Now this particular change in the very tin is known as the rusting here. Now what is the, how we can define the chemical reaction of rusting here is that whenever a metal, when it is kept in open, okay, and if it comes in contact with air, water or moisture, okay, then they will start to react with them, okay, and when they will start to react with them, the chemical reaction is going to occur and slowly the metal will start to degrade, okay, that means the qualities of the metal is going to get deteriorated, okay. Now this very particular reaction is known as the rusting here, okay, and then very yellow color, sorry, red color, the substance that is developed on the tin or any other metal, on the iron, that is known as the rust, okay. Now how can you prevent the rusting? You might have seen that many people, they used to paint their roof, okay. Now by painting also, you will be able to protect the particular thing from rusting, okay. This is a very general method that you used to do. Next thing that you can do is oiling, okay. Oiling, if you keep the metal inside the oil, then at a very particular place, no water or no air can go inside. Since no air and no water can go inside the well, the metal will be free from rusting, okay. And the other or the last way of preventing the rusting is by coating the metal with the help of zinc metal, okay. Now the iron metal or any other metal which have a tendency to get rust, you can coat them with the help of zinc metal. That means you have to put one layer of zinc metal. Now this zinc metal is very stable, okay, and it will not allow the metal to get rust, okay. And this process of coating the metal with the help of zinc metal is known as the galvanization, okay. So that's all from this particular chapter, okay. So try to go briefly to the topic and try to have the proper concept of different types of reaction here. Thank you.
Stay home, stay safe, do it for yourselves, do it for your family, do it for India. Let's break the chain of COVID-19. Hum Hum Ye Kamyaab, Jai Hind.